We have already seen how the horizontal coordinate system works, but it is not very useful to make record of observations. So, we should work towards some kind of absolute coordinate system. In geography, you have actually encountered one form of absolute coordinate system, a system to show or locate places on surface of Earth. System we know as latitudes and longitudes. How latitudes and longitudes work? Just a quick recall. For latitudes, we take Earth's equator as our reference, and then we measure how many degrees above equator, how many degrees below equator a place is. So, if some place is 50 degrees north, that means it is 50 degrees above equator. 40 degrees south means 40 degrees below equator. All the way up to north pole, if you go, it will be 90 degrees north, south pole 90 degrees south, and equator is 0 degrees. Longitudes, we take some reference circle. In general, all longitudes we may think it is they are equal. So, just for our convenience, we have taken reference, which is the longitude which passes through Greenwich, town of Greenwich in UK. And from that reference circle, we start measuring east towards east or towards west. We go all the way 0 to 180 east, 0 to 180 west. We are going to use very similar system in the sky. We call it equatorial coordinate system. For that, we need references. For latitudes and longitudes, we had two references. One was our equator, second was Greenwich Meridian. For the celestial system, we again use two references. The black circle here is celestial equator, which is nothing but projection of Earth's equator on celestial sphere. And for the vertical reference, we use again this green line. What is that green line? That is the line, the vertical meridian, which is passing through the first point of Aries or vernal equinox point. How we define vernal equinox point? If you remember, the vernal equinox point is where equator and ecliptic, which is the red circle, they meet each other, and beyond that point, ecliptic starts going above equator. So, it is ascending node of the ecliptic. So, that is the vernal equinox point. So, line passing through the vernal equinox point is going to be our vertical reference line. How we will use that? First, like latitude, we define a coordinate which is called declination. Declination usually shown by symbol delta. It just tells you how high the star is from the equator. Exactly like latitude, there is no difference at all. So, north celestial pole, its declination will be 90 degrees. South celestial pole, its declination will be minus 90 degrees. And equator, by definition, will be 0 degrees. Now, then we go to the second coordinate. Now, how this delta is useful? This delta will also tell you which stars are visible from your location and which stars are not. So, for example, suppose you are living in somewhere in northern hemisphere. I can see almost all stars of northern hemisphere, but I will not be able to see the southern celestial pole. If you are in southern hemisphere, you will see all stars of southern hemisphere, but you may not see some stars around north celestial pole. So, which zone is excluded and which zone is included from your location? For that, if you just imagine how this works out, we can say if declination of a star is more than 90 minus 5, where 5 is latitude of your place, then that star will never set at your location. Suppose you are in Mumbai, where latitude is 19 degrees. So, what you put 19 degrees here, 90 minus 19, you get 71 degrees. So, any star whose declination is more than 71 degrees will always remain in your sky. It will be a circumpolar star or never setting star. Conversely, if you take any star whose declination is less than 5 minus 90, then that star will be never rising star in your location. So, for Mumbai, you put 19 here, 19 minus 19 minus 71, all stars with declination less than minus 71 will never be seen in Mumbai. The second coordinate is similar to longitude, we call it right ascension RA, and it is given by symbol alpha. It is measured from the vernal equinox meridian eastwards and it is measured in hours. It is not measured in degrees. Declination we were measuring in degrees, longitudes also we measure in degrees, but here this coordinate is measured in hours. Why? I will come to that in a minute, but right now it's remember it is hours. So vernal equinox, the right ascension will be 0 hours. Summer solstice, right ascension will be 6 hours, autumnal equinox 12 hours, winter solstice 18 hours. And if you come all the way full circle, it will go from 0 hours, it will come to 24 hours, full circle is 24 hours, which is corresponding to 60 degrees. So you already know that sky rotates by about 15 degrees in 1 hour. So, 15 degrees of sky is equivalent to 1 hour of RA. So, in every hour, RA changes by 1 hour. Now, you have got a good idea why I am using hours instead of degrees. The rotation of sky also gives you sidereal time. And the sidereal time, hour angle and right ascension are connected to each other. That is why we use same unit for all three. Hour angle is also measured in hours, sidereal time is measured in hours, right ascension is also measured in hours, and that is related by right ascension is sidereal time minus hour angle. Hour angle, as you know, is always measured eastwards. Last thing to remember, these are fairly absolute coordinates. So, if I make a record that this star was seen at this RA and this deck, or alpha delta, whichever way you want to call it, and you can tell somebody in some other country, then they can easily find the same star at same coordinates. So, they are fairly absolute. But the only problem is our one of the reference lines is this passing the meridian passing through the vernal equinox point. You know, because of precession, the vernal equinox point keeps moving slowly. So, because of that, there is a slight movement of this reference line itself. And because of that, RA decks will keep changing if you keep observing for a very long time. Typically, when you see RA deck of any star or any celestial object reported, after that in bracket, they will also mention the reference date. Typically, you will see it is mentioned as J2000.0, or in bracket, in Stellarium they will say J2000.0, they will also say of current date. That means as of today or to 2023, these are the coordinates of this star, but as on 1st January 2000, that is 2000.0, these were the coordinates, and you will notice there is a small difference. So, when you want to make a precise reporting of RA decks of any star, you should not only mention RA deck, you should also mention the corresponding epoch.